When most people think of the most dangerous volcano in the lower 48 U.S. states, they generally think of a single system, Mount St. Helens. Yet, despite having produced 44 separate volcanic eruptions in the last 5,000 years, including 8 equal in size or larger than its infamous 1980 eruption, it is not the most dangerous volcano. Rather, listed as a highly dangerous so-called decade volcano among the likes of Vesuvius in Italy and Merapi in Indonesia is a different volcano, Mount Rainier. The reason? An unusual layer of white, yellowish-brown rock found downstream of Mount Rainier. This specific rock unit can be found over a wide area in the ground, including an area northeast of Tacoma, in Puyallup, Greenwater, Auburn, and Buckley. It does not represent a layer of ash, but rather something far more destructive, one of the world's largest recent lahars, the Osceola Lahar. Approximately 5,600 years ago, a large section of Mount Rainier collapsed, creating a debris flow which mixed the volcanic products from an ongoing eruption. This mass of material was subsequently funneled into a series of river channels, overtopping their sides with a wall of mud and superheated rock up to 200 feet in height. This lahar would go on to cover 220 square miles or 550 square kilometers of land and material, traveling all the way to Puget Sound and wiping out all vegetation in this large-scale natural disaster. Today, more than 100,000 people live on top of this recent lahar deposit, and all would be placed at risk if a similar event was to occur again. Since Mount Rainier is covered by a thick series of glaciers, any future eruption will be guaranteed to melt large sections of overlying ice, once again placing tens if not hundreds of thousands of people at risk. So, why did this lahar occur, and how often do events of this magnitude occur? This video will answer these two questions and discuss why Mount Rainier truly is a volcano some scientists do not want to witness another eruption from. Today, Mount Rainier is quite an impressive stratovolcano as it stands at 14,411 feet tall. Yet, in 3600 BCE, the volcano was even taller, being the tallest point in the lower 48 US states. At the time, Mount Rainier was somewhere between 15,000 and 16,000 feet in height. At the time, the volcano was undergoing a small-scale series of phreatic eruptions, which marked the beginning of a longer VEI-3 explosive eruption sequence. Large swaths of the northern flank of Mount Rainier had turned shades of white, yellow, and red due to significant hydrothermal alteration. This replaced significant quantities of harder volcanic rock with clay, which was incredibly prone to erosion. As the phreatic phase of the eruption ended, magma interacted with the volcano's water table, creating a series of powerful explosions. This sent particles of ash and lava down Rainier's slopes, resulting in 3 small-scale lahars. As the eruption progressed, it soon changed to purely magmatic activity. Then, due in part to the ongoing eruption, a water-rich avalanche began on the volcano. This avalanche soon cascaded to include boulders of rock, and soon an entire slope of the hydrothermally altered Mount Rainier. As 3.8 cubic kilometers of rock collapsed to the north and northeast, the volcano lost more than 1,000 feet in height. This material was largely funneled into a river channel where it overtopped many natural barriers and carrying with it large logs from ripped out trees. With a high density, this lahar moved at 42 miles per hour, destroying everything in its path. Although much of the lahar's material was deposited along the way, by 3 hours later it reached Puget Sound. What had just occurred was Mount Rainier's largest known lahar. Luckily, events of a similar magnitude are incredibly rare, repeating at a rate of less than once every 10,000 years. However, lahars which are 10 to 20 times smaller occur about once every 1,000 to 2,500 years from this volcano, having a similarly destructive effect over a lesser area. Here is a quick US Geological Survey map of areas covered by recent lahars from Mount Rainier. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Zem for supporting this channel.